everybody. I hope you are doing well. It is so lovely to be back with you. I have missed doing these videos. It has been so long since we've sat down and had a chat and had a conversation, and I've missed you. Like, a lot has changed, guys. Like, let's be honest, a lot has changed. And you know, I wonder if things have changed with you. Let me know, what have you been up to in this time that we have been away? I think it's been probably around 6 months since I've sat down and filled you in with what's been going on, because I have had a baby. Now, there was so many different videos that I wanted to film when Solomon was born, but turns out, guys, having a newborn baby is actually a full-time job. It is real, like, it is intense, and trying to run a business on the side as well just meant that YouTube was just not a priority at all. So I'm so sorry that we stopped and that we paused in that season of my life, but nevertheless, I'm back and I'm here to fill you in with every single detail, starting with letting you know what my birth was like. Now, I gave birth during the coronavirus pandemic. Like, I was one of those people. To be honest, it was still such an amazing experience, regardless of the fact that my family couldn't come in, and regardless of the fact that, you know, there were so many different things, you had to wear masks, and it was such an intense environment. It was still probably up there with one of the most incredible experiences of my whole entire life. I gave birth to Solomon on the 1st of August 2020, which feels like a lifetime ago now. On my due day on the 29th, the midwife looked at me and basically was like, this baby is not coming anytime soon. And that was because Solomon had decided to worm himself out of the birth canal and just wanted to be back swimming in the womb again, which, totally fine, like, crack on, Sol. Obviously that meant that he wasn't going to be coming, so she put me in for an induction, all that kind of stuff, which left me, to be honest, feeling a little bit gutted, because I'd reached the end of my pregnancy, and anyone who's ever been pregnant, or if you're ever going to be pregnant, by the time you reach the end of your pregnancy, you are very much ready to get that kid out. I wanted to get back to normal, I wanted to just enjoy with my baby, meet him. But anyway, Solomon had a different plan, because the next day then, no, I got my dates wrong, because then on the 31st of July, I started going in to labour. I had no idea what it would be like when I first started going into labour. Me and Ben, it was a lovely day, we decided to go to the beach. There's a whole different story in that when we actually arrived to the beach, it was disgusting weather, and my mother was there and my sister, and they were like, why have you brought us to this beach? It's not even sunny. But that's besides the point. We got home that night and decided, let's go for a barbecue on a different beach and try it again and just enjoy the last of the summer night. We just found out that Sol probably wasn't coming for another 10 days. So we were just gonna enjoy the last couple of days that we could without him as a couple. But actually, that never ended up happening, because I lay down on the couch and I had like what was like a period pain. I just texted my mother saying, actually, I just really don't feel well. I had a bad tummy. I just didn't, like, I felt really fatigued and I just didn't wanna really go out. So I just said to her, you know, I'm sorry, I'm not going to come in. And she was like, oh, is this it? And I was like, no, probably not, because I just was not thinking that it would ever come this fast now, because the midwife had said that it wasn't really going to be happening. Total disclosure, I had not actually spent much time on the birthing ball, and she actually, the midwife, let me know as well that Solomon was back to back, which is not a position that you want your baby to be in. So she said, please get on the birthing ball and sort of like lean forward and try and get him to turn. I had these pains, I thought, I'll just sit on the birthing ball. And I actually put Star Wars on, because I really, really love Star Wars. So I thought, what better than to just sit here on the bouncy ball, like bounce, 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 and watch Star Wars. And that's what I did. And then the period pains quickly turned to little contractions. And I thought, okay, this is it. Braxton Hicks don't really come in patterns, so once these started having, like, you know, contraction, then it would be like 10 minutes, then another contraction, then like 10 minutes. And you kind of just know, like, I just knew that this was it. But I didn't really say anything, because I was a bit like, oh gosh, like, what is happening? Then as I was bouncing the ball, I thought, right, I'm gonna go to the toilet. But also, like, things down there just didn't really feel good. Like, I felt like there was something happening, something not right. So I went to the toilet, and there was actually fresh blood in my underwear. I'm so sorry if you didn't want to know that, but you know, you did click on this to hear my labor story. So anybody who's ever been pregnant or is pregnant will know that whenever there's fresh blood, you always just get a little bit worried. So I called my midwife and I just explained to her what was happening. And she just said, hey, I think you should probably come down. Let's just check you over. So I let Ben know. I just said, you know, oh, by the way, there's a little bit of blood in my underwear. I need to go and see the midwife. She needs to check me over. And we ended up going to the hospital. So we took a hospital bag, just in case. I knew what was really going to be happening. We hadn't had dinner either, so I had to stop off from McDonald's on the way. I was thinking, if I am going to do this, if I am going to go into labor, I need to be fueled up with a quarter pounder and a McDonald's fat Coke right next to me. That's exactly what I did. We got to the hospital, and obviously because of COVID, Ben couldn't come in with me, so I just went upstairs in labor. Obviously I drove the whole time just holding the handle of the car, like every time I had a contraction. So we got to the hospital and I just went in, and I think because of COVID everyone was just so much more kind. I was in labor and I was coming in all by myself, and it's quite daunting, especially when it's your first pregnancy, your first experience of labor. It's such a strange experience because you're literally walking into the unknown and you have no idea what it's going to be like. And as much as you write a birthing plan, it never ever goes to plan. I lay down and they kind of monitored me and kind of put me on all of these machine things and monitored baby's heartbeat, all that. They did confirm that I was in labor. They did confirm that the baby was on his way. But what they couldn't really say was where the blood was coming from. But what they did know as well was that every time I was having a contraction, that Solomon's heart rate was actually dropping. So because his heart rate was dropping, they said, you know, actually we need to keep you in overnight. We just want to monitor you, monitor baby, make sure that obviously as you progress in labor, nothing really bad happens. I was so expecting to go home. So I didn't have a phone charger. My phone was on 20%. So I explained to Ben, I just said, look, if I'm going to do this, I need to have my phone on charge so I can contact you at any time. With COVID, he was only actually allowed to come in, I think, when I was like 4 centimeters, like dilated and like really in full-blown active labor. I literally wanted to be ready at whatever point that was to let him know to come in because I didn't want him to miss a thing. So I said, can you just pop to Tesco and just get me a phone charger, please? By the time he'd come back from the shop, they'd already said, we need to break your waters. The baby is still in distress, so we just want to hurry it up, get him going. Obviously, because he was back to back as well and he wasn't properly in the birth canal, they just wanted to really move it along and see what they could do to help us both out. They broke my waters and said that obviously Ben could come up. But guys, let me just put it out there right now. Labor is legit. Like, it is serious. So I decided to have an epidural just because I just couldn't cope with the pain. It was actually horrific. Because he was back to back, I didn't even get a break from every contraction. I was having the contractions and then I was having the excruciating back pain and another contraction, and I just was not having a good time. And I remember being on gas and it and saying to the woman, this is not working. She was like, yes, it is. I was like, I'm telling you now, this gas and it is not working. They were like, okay, let's give this girl what she wants. Let's give her an epidural. And they did. But anyway, when they broke my waters, he'd be back in 2 hours to check on me. And by the time he'd come back in 2 hours, I'd been chilling with my epidural with Ben next to me. We'd been talking, eating strawberries. Honestly, it got lovely once that epidural kicked in. I was just chilling, enjoying with the midwife and Ben and everybody watching TV. It was actually lovely, all for about half an hour before he came back in and said to me that I was fully dilated and it was time to push. Solomon was quite far up the birth canal still. He wasn't far enough down for me to actually give birth without help. They said it would probably be best for me to go to theatre should they need to intervene in any way. So when we got to theatre, they basically numbed me the whole way down and I couldn't feel a thing. And they put me, you know, ready to go and I was in the gown. It was really strange because what was a really nice and chilled experience this far actually then kind of turned into a bit of a, oh gosh, this is a bit serious. Like, there's actual problems here. Like, this just getting a bit more, oh. In your birth plan, they never really talked to you about the possibilities of having to go to theatre. And so then when it became the reality that I was sat there in that freezing cold theatre room, I just remember shaking with just like shock and anxiety and like, what is about to happen? And I was looking at Ben and he was all positive and all the doctors were all positive, and I just was like looking at the floor like, Oh my gosh, I can't believe this is happening. So little Solomon was born in that theatre room at 2 o'clock on the 1st of August, 2020. When he came out, he needed a little bit of help because he had the cord wrapped around his neck, which was causing his heart rate issues. So they unwrapped him and they kind of gave him a bit of a on the old oxygen because he didn't come out crying. And for any mother who's given birth or is about to give birth, like, that's what you look for. I don't know if it's because of the films or whatever, but you look for that baby cry. And when that didn't come, oh my gosh, the panic. But they were like, it's fine, and literally a couple of minutes later, there he was screaming his head off. So it was literally fine. Ben got to hold him first, and Ben brought him over to me because obviously they were sorting me out, because I ended up having forceps and an episiotomy, so the recovery was ridiculous. But he brought him over to me and I just went like, hey baby, like that to him. And I remember him just looking at me like with these big eyes, and everyone just went, oh, he knows his mum. And I was like, yes he does, because guys, those post-labor hormones are legit. And I just remember feeling so emotional and so teary, like looking at everything that had happened and my son that was there, and just holding him and kissing him and being with him was just the most insane moment. Having a baby and those first moments with them are just so, so, so special, and I cannot wait to experience that again with more babies and more kids. Like, oh, it's just magical. 2 hours after our little Solly Ollie was born, his breathing changed. Now, what I didn't tell you was when they broke my waters, there was actually meconium, which is like the science word, the doctor word, for poo. So basically, he pooed in me and then he swallowed his poo. Because that had happened, he had an infection. There was like presumed sepsis, all that kind of stuff. So they needed to basically take him to monitor him and kind of help him get back. They took him to the intensive care unit where he was then put on the pipes and stuff. I don't think I felt the effects of COVID until then. When they took Sol to ICU, and then Ben went home, obviously I was like all alone, and they took me to this ward with all new mums, and they all had their babies, and I was just there by myself, and they were all FaceTiming all of their friends and family, which was lovely, and FaceTiming their babies and saying, look, there he is, and feeding them and having all this beautiful enjoyment, which was so nice. But I was also there in the corner by the window with no baby, worrying my little heart out about what's gonna happen. I never have texted my mum and prayed so much in my whole entire life. It really was probably one of the hardest, maybe not the worst, but the hardest days of my life. Because when you have a baby, you always expect that you're gonna have a great labor, and after that, you're gonna be able to take your baby home and begin your life as a family. When that didn't happen, it just hit me like a ton of bricks. All of a sudden, my baby that I just held was in intensive care on oxygen and piped up. I've put a couple of things in here now for you to like be able to see what he was like and what the experience was. But honestly, there is nothing harder than seeing your baby piped up and, you know, in all the machine. All you want to be able to do is be there for your baby and help your baby. And I remember feeling so helpless and just like, I can't do anything to help him and he's on his own. And it was just horrible. Because of COVID, I couldn't see him at the same time as Ben. So literally, I didn't see Ben for the first couple of days after Saul was born. I'm a huge girl of faith. I love Jesus and I have done my whole entire life. And I really think that in that time is probably the time where I have lent on him and really depended on him more than anything. I think when you're in that situation where your little one is really fighting a little bit for their health and their well-being, you have to really kind of put your trust in God a little bit and just hope that, you know, he'll help the little guy out, help him come to full recovery. And, you know, I don't know if you have a faith, but even in those moments, you have to kind of put your trust even in the doctors. And so you have to have some level of trust in somebody else. And it's so tough, especially as a new mum, because all you want to be able to do is provide for your baby and give them what they need. And in that moment, I couldn't. I couldn't feed my baby like all the other mums. I couldn't hold my baby like the other mums. I couldn't FaceTime my family like the other mums because mine was in intensive care on all the beeps and the machines. So labour itself was very quick. I was in active labour for 1 hour and 12 minutes. So it did all progress really, really quickly. And by far, I think the hardest thing was having Sol then in intensive care afterwards, because it really really was the most heart-wrenching thing, seeing my baby like that and feeling completely helpless, and also not being able to have Ben with me in those moments. I think because of COVID, we weren't allowed to see each other because I couldn't have visitors, and when he was seeing Solomon, they weren't allowed more than one person there, regardless of households or anything. I went in on the Friday and I was out on the Monday, so it wasn't all bad. He recovered so quickly, and again, I'm a girl of faith, so I'm convinced that, you know, God really stepped in there, because his infection rate was so bad that they said that we'd be in for at least a week, and it ended up that he recovered so quickly that we were out on the Monday. So some might say that it was chance, but I really believe that just that was God coming through. And on that Monday when we got home, I got to see my family and they got to meet Solomon for the first time, and we got to just be a little unit of three, and it was the most just beautiful thing. We got to begin our life as a family of three, and it was so special. So yeah, giving birth for me is not something that I am particularly looking forward to with other babies. And I don't really know how it's gonna go, because obviously it's gonna be different every single time. But yeah, so that was my birth experience and my hospital experience with little Solobomb, as we call him. The elements of that that were a bit scary, but overall it was really the best experience, because regardless of any pain or shock or stress or anything, I got my baby boy at the end of it, and he is the most special thing. And I know he's 5 months old now, so this video is so late, but he is amazing. He's so smiley and so beautiful, and if you want to see any of that, please, like, if you don't already follow me, head to my Instagram. I post about him probably every day. So thank you for watching. Please let me know what your stories are. If you've given birth, like, was your experience like mine? Did you give birth during COVID? Are you gonna be giving birth during COVID? Are you a bit nervous about it? Please let me know. I would actually love to chat to you about it. Please subscribe if you wanna see a little bit more. But aside from that, I hope you have the most fantastic day. Thank you for watching. I love you very, very, very much, and I will see you very soon.